racing reindeer heat up freezing Finland. Banana hammock wearing islanders attack a fruit-filled triathlon. Boxing brainiacs battle in Berlin. An Austrian outdoorsman answer nature's call. The world's most bizarre sports revealed on Games of Strange. Finland, home of racers, trophies, more reindeer, more racers, and people enjoying reindeer races. Once a year, the Sami, Finland's indigenous people, meet on a frozen lake to stage a unique competition, the Kingdom's Reindeer Race. This weekend is a treasured celebration of old Arctic traditions.
No joo, kulttuurihan on tärkeä. Meillähän on identiteetti tärkeä, ollaanko me suomalaisia tai ollaanko me lappilaisia ja sitten erikseen vielä saamelaisia.
The first Kingdom's Race was held in 1950, but reindeer racing dates back to the 17th century when the Sami raced one another to church to get the best seats. This guy probably sat in the back. Thirty-five-year-old reindeer racer Hannah is feeling some pressure. Her goggles are on too tight. She also feels the pressure to win. In real life, she pushes beds through a hospital corridor as a nurse. Today, she pushes her reindeer to victory. And her reindeer team responds, overcoming a late jump out of the gate by flying down the track. Despite their bulky size, reindeer can run faster than you, or anyone you know, up to 35 miles an hour. Those hooves can move. And they move just fast enough for the win.
First when we started, he got a little late. I have trusted the reindeer, so that's why we put him in the sprint this time, and it worked.
This win boosts Hannah's confidence for the race. But what about her reindeer? It's like that old Sami saying, a confident reindeer is sometimes faster than a less confident reindeer.
As a reindeer rider, I have to be at least 15 years old, and I have to weigh at least 60 kilograms with all the equipments like helmet and neck protection and skis. We are not allowed to talk or shout. The others can be bothered of that. We can shh, shh, or keep a little noise. We all have our own techniques, what we use. And when you race all the season, you learn how to steer your reindeer.
Steering a reindeer can be very difficult, since most reindeer have no idea what a race is.
Well, some say that they are not intelligent, but they are. But they can be pretty nervous, so then they don't understand anything.
Wow. Clearly, reindeer are not bred for racing. Instead, owners select the fastest and smartest reindeer from their herd while they're still calves. Only 1 in 100 reindeer has what it takes to race competitively. And based on what happens to the chosen few, they may not want to get selected.
When they are 4 or 5 years old, they castrated. We take the pliers and to the balls. And then they will be bigger and stronger, more fat, and they will not have any sex with the other reindeer.
Does Hannah's reindeer have what it takes today? The first heat of the Kingdom's race is on its way. It's a group run over 1,000 meters long. Sadly, Hannah and her reindeer finish in eighth place after the first heat. Not good.
There are a little bit of new snow there, so the skis doesn't go very well in that.
Hannah begins her second and final run. Unlike the first heat, this is raced individually over 2,000 meters. The times for runs 1 and 2 will be combined to determine the final standings. Hannah ends up setting a solid but not unbeatable time. Her fate now lies in the hands and hooves of the next riders. It's a nail-biting series of moments for Hannah. Yes, Hannah's time holds up. Hannah's masterful second run land her the title Queen of Reindeer Racing.
Well, it's good to win this competition because it could be a once in a lifetime.
Today, a Games of Strange dream came true. Tomorrow, Hannah will go back to being a nurse and her reindeer will, well, still be a reindeer. And hopefully stay away from scissor happy Ari. Time to trade snow for sun and reindeer for giant stone heads? Over 2,000 miles west of Chile and over 4,000 miles east of New Zealand, Easter Island is as remote as it is mysterious. It's known primarily for its colossal moai, over 800 ancient stone heads who today are in for an eyeful. Once a year, 10 scantily clad, banana-carrying local athletes compete in the Rapa Nui Triathlon. This unique triathlon is composed of self-made canoe paddling, sprinting around the lake while carrying bananas, a quick sprint without bananas, and a final reed float assisted swim to the finish. Leon Pagarati, or Mercy as his friends call him, has dreamt of winning this race his whole life.
Triatlón, 2 meses a full. Este es mi último día de entrenamiento, de lunes a lunes, pero domingo más relajado. Y mi entrenamiento es correr, nadar, surf, canotaje.
The race begins with canoeing. Here, the athletes must power themselves through the water, leaving just enough strength to sprint around the lake. After the run, you must paddle across the lake atop a float of reeds. Mercy builds one of these traditional Rapa Nui floats with Tu'u Ma'eke, who, after winning 15 times, knows the hardest part of training isn't what you do, it's what you don't do.
No tener relaciones. Sexo. Nada. Stop cerveza. Stop comer mal. Stop sexo. Todos son 1 o 2 meses.
Ranu Raraku, the volcanic quarry from which the nearly 900 moai on the island were built. It's the breathtaking backdrop of the Rapa Nui Triathlon. Competitors first paddle 430 yards across a crater lake, then circle the water with 45 pounds of bananas, drop the bananas, and climb past the moai, and finally cross the lake atop a bundle of reeds. For many Rapa Nui, this triathlon is the most important cultural event of the year. Today, most watching expect another victory for Mercy's main opponent, two-time winner and reigning champion, Carlos Haoa.
Sacó el récord, le ganó al Tuman record en tiempo, 16.5.
Can Mercy or anyone else dethrone this record-setting title holder? 10 athletes head to head, 430 yards of volcanic lagoon stretched out before them. Halfway across the lake, Mercy in second position and Carlos in third begin to separate themselves from the pack. But once they reach the bank, Carlos leaps in front of Mercy, grabbing his bananas and running like someone's trying to steal them. The track around the lake is roughly 1,000 yards long, which probably feels like 1,000 miles while running barefoot on uneven ground with 45 pounds of fruit on your shoulders. Carlos and Mercy both finish the lake lap and drop their bananas, hoping they still have enough potassium in the tank to fuel their uphill sprint past the ancient Moai. The triathletes now race down the volcano to the other side of the lake, carrying quivers reminiscent of ancient Rapa Nui warriors. Mercy manages to catch Carlos on the water, and the two men race neck and neck to the finish. They reach the bank nearly simultaneously, but Carlos Haoa pops up first, narrowly winning the Rapa Nui Triathlon for the third time in a row. Mercy's finishing sprint pushed Carlos to a new race record of 16 minutes and 39 seconds.
Estoy emocionado de haber ganado este año acá, este circuito. Ojalá seguir ganando todos los años y llegar a superar la meta, pero eso hay que hacerlo.
A near miss motivates Mercy to redouble his banana hauling efforts for next year.
Me siento mejor, correr, correr, más correr, porque en lo otro estoy bien. Puro correr, ¿no? El primero ahora, no entrené mucho este año.
And now to Germany for the world's most intellectual fistfight. Welcome to the most complete test of both mind and body, that is, chess boxing. Rooks, hooks, pawns, and punches.
Ein Schlag auf den Kopf ist gar nicht so schlimm. Schlimmste ist wirklich die Gedanken.
Reigning world champion Sven Rock trains daily as he prepares to defend his title.
Ich würde schon sagen, dass es in meiner Karriere bis jetzt der wichtigste Kampf ist.
For challenger Jonathan Rodriguez Vega, chess boxing is more than just a new sport. It is a chance of redemption.
En cierto modo sí, porque me sacó de un ambiente diferente al que tiene que debería tener un deportista. Había hecho un cambio en mi vida bastante drástico.
When he's not busy trading right hands and taking kings in the ring, Sven Rock works as a firefighter in Berlin. That's right, he's a professional firefighter who's also a champion boxer and chess player. And you thought you were the man.
Ich wollte einfach was Neues probieren, eine neue Qualität dazu bringen. Und im Schachboxen habe ich dann einfach das gefunden, im Prinzip das Schach geistig mich noch mehr zu fordern, die scheinbaren Polaritäten zusammenzubringen. Das war dann der ausschlaggebende Punkt, zum Schachboxen zu kommen.
Sven loves the excitement of firefighting and chess boxing. Both push him to his physical and mental limits. Both require one to make important mental decisions quickly under extreme physical exhaustion. Working out after work while most people relax or party isn't always easy. But Sven isn't most people. He lives to be challenged.
Kraft und Motivation für das viele Training ist im Prinzip für mich, mich selbst zu fordern, auf den Punkt hin zu trainieren und da zu zeigen, was ich gemacht habe.
Challenger Jonathan Rodriguez Vega was once part of the Spanish Olympic team, but then he got injured and fell into depression. It looked like his boxing life was over until he found chess boxing.
Bueno, pues me despertó el interés otra vez por el deporte. Como te estaba diciendo, el que la gente del chess boxing siguiera interesada que participara con ellos en competiciones me despertó el gusanillo otra vez del deporte, del boxeo sobre todo.
Intellectual Fight Night is here in Berlin's famous Columbia Arena. Time for the Chess Boxing World Championship. 1,000 fans are eager to see world-caliber chess being played by men who could punch you out of your chair as easily as they could take your bishop. Backstage, Jonathan gets himself ready.
Ya tengo mi cabeza al ring y todo el momento en el que voy a estar arriba. Estoy ya pensando, esto es como si estuviera en el ring sin estar físicamente.
Jonathan starts strong, taking control of the chessboard in the opening round.
And the next move is coming. Until now, everything is open. Let's have a look on the clocks.
Ah, das war schon in dieser Runde.
3 minutes of boxing follow 3 minutes of chess in each round. Sven knows Jonathan has dangerous knockout power and sticks to a strategy of defensive boxing. However, Jonathan is landing more punches. If he can't get a checkmate, he'll lose his title.
Man kommt mit einem hohen Puls aus dem Boxen raus, viel Adrenalin. Und das Erste, was man will dasselbe machen, was man im Boxen macht. Man will angreifen.
Sven catches up to Jonathan on the chess table. He's back in the match, providing he can stay on his feet.
Weil sich im Boxen letzten Endes vorne sieht.
Sven ends up defending a few of Jonathan's punches with his face over the next few rounds, but refuses to fall down.
Und es geht weiter. Hat auf E1 genommen.
The sixth and final round. Sven must get a checkmate or his reign is over. And that's exactly what he does. Jonathan's one mistake is a costly one. And Sven Rock remains chess boxing world champion. He celebrates the happiest day of his life. Jonathan Rodriguez Vega will come back next year and challenge Sven once again in this Game of Strange. And now to the wild for our final sport. These men don't have indigestion. They are actually in a competition. The objective, to woo the hearts of does or the points of judges with their finest stag call impression. Once a year, the world's best livestock thespians gather in the heart of Europe.
Kommen nicht sagen, dass dies lächerlich gefunden wird.
The Stag Calling Championship in the Czech Republic is where vocal masters of this 100-year-old tradition come together from across Europe to battle, grunt to grunt. In the Austrian province of Salzburg, head forester Fritz Huchleitner and his son Julian trek through the local hunting territory. Before taking their vocal talents to the European Championship of Deer Calling, They want to test their skills in front of the most critical audience.
Der Hirschhof hat gesagt, für die jagdliche Praxis existiert schon, weiß nicht, 100, 150 Jahre mit diversen Instrumenten. Und vor 12, 13 Jahren hat sich eben das dann zu einem Wettkampf entwickelt, wo sie also die Besten des Hirschhofes eben da gemessen haben. Und mittlerweile hat sich eigentlich zu einem veritablen Wettbewerb entwickelt, der eben in Form einer Hirschhof-Europameisterschaft abgehalten wird.
In hunting, this technique is used to allure a deer searching for a mate into the open where it can be shot through the heart. Love can be cruel sometimes. This year, the European Championship of Stag Calling is held at a castle in the Czech Republic. Fritz and Julian are eager to bellow their way to the top of the competition. 30 contestants from 10 different nations will compete in three disciplines: a grumpy sound known as Old Stag Away from Herd, a seductive croon known as Young Stag Searching, and the pugnacious grunt of Calling Duel of Two Stags. All are very different. Showtime. Now, a jury will award points from 1 to 6 based on accuracy.
Danke, Jury.
Rein des Animalisch muss da sein, ne? So, er darf nicht, dass er mein Herz ruft, so, dass man das so hört, ne? Sondern es muss.
It's Julian's turn. At 14 years old, he is the youngest competitor in this year's field.
Dann gehe ich mal auf die Bühne auf und bin ein bisschen nervös. Und auch ein Ding mit kleinen Hirschen.
Ja, was geht mir durch den Kopf? Ich konzentriere mich einmal voll. Dann ziehe ich einmal die tiefe Luft ein, bis oben ins Zwerchfell. Natürlich ist eine entscheidende oder eine schneidige Spannung da.
Johanna Hookleitner is moved by her son's and husband's curdling groans. But does the jury share her enthusiasm?
Ich selber jetzt richtig total nervös. Man fiebert schon total mit. Gerade jetzt vom Julian und vom Fritz, aber ich glaube, sie haben es schon gut gemacht.
The final scores are tallied.
Glücklicher 7. Platz.
Friedrich Hookleitner aus der Jahr.
Auf der 5. Platz.
Julian Hochleitner, Austria!
Julian comes in 5th, besting his father and the rest of the Austrian delegation.
Ich kann nicht sagen, was mir am meisten gefreut hat, freut mich. Dass ich 7. geworden bin. Und der 5. Platz vom Buben. Super.
As Fritz passes the torch to Julian, this family's Call of the Wild echoes loud and proud. Come back next time for more wild, weird, new, ancient, exhilarating, and innovating Games of Strange.